我们现在看啊，《创世纪》的五十章。
Please turn to Genesis chapter 50.
五十章的十九节。
Genesis chapter 50, verse 19.
创世纪五十章十九节，请读。
Genesis chapter 50, verse 19. Joseph said to them, "Do not be afraid, for am I in the place of God?"
在这个地方，约瑟对他的哥哥说，我岂能代替神呢？
Joseph said to his brothers, "Am I in the place of God?"
这句话代表约瑟的灵性。
From his words, we can see his spiritual character.
那为什么他说我岂能代替神呢？
Why did he say, "Am I in the place of God?"
二十节就是一个解释。
Verse 22 gives the explanation.
请读。
Verse 20, "But as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to bring it about as it is this day, to save many people alive."
在这个地方，约瑟看到神的意思原来是好的。
At this moment, Joseph realized that God meant it for good.
约瑟在17岁的时候，神让他做两个梦。
God gave Joseph two dreams when Joseph was 17 years old.
这个两个梦都是在预言约瑟将来要伟大，他的兄弟都要在他的下面。
Both dreams foretold that Joseph will one day be great, and his brothers will bow down to him.
那这两个梦在约瑟被提拔做宰相的时候就已经实现了。
And both dreams came true when Joseph was made prime minister.
所以到他三十岁的时候他看到他十七岁所没有看到神的美好的意思。
Now Joseph was 30 years old, and he was able to see what he originally could not see, which was God meant it for good.
所以这讲神的意思是好的。那神的意思是什么？
God meant it for good, and what was God's will?
神的意思就是要借着他在埃及当宰相来养活神的选民。
God's intention was to make Joseph the prime minister of Egypt so as to save God's people.
约瑟30岁当了宰相。
Joseph became prime minister when he was 30.
然后他110岁死了。
And he died at the age of 110.
所以看起来他在埃及当宰相时间相当的长。
So he was a prime minister for a long time in Egypt.
但是我们从创世纪可以看到约瑟的生活有两个层面。
In the book of Genesis, we can see two aspects to Joseph's life.
一个层面就是埃及人所看到有一个以色列人来到我们当中，现在做宰相，非常精明，非常能干。
The first aspect is what the public saw, that a Hebrew came down to Egypt and became and was elevated to be the prime minister, and he is a very capable person.
他也真的忠心办事毫无错误把这个职分做得很好。
And he is faithful in all his responsibilities and manages everything very well.
这个就是一般人所看到一个层面。
And this was what the typical person saw.
但是约瑟了解神让他当宰相有一个更高的目的。
But at the same time, Joseph understood that God made him prime minister for a higher purpose.
所以英文赞美诗有一首的诗歌有一句话就是 higher purpose, 就是更高的目的。
So there's a hymn in our hymn book that talks about the higher purpose of God.
那这个更高的目的就是从神来的目的。
And this higher purpose comes from God.
所以很显然神让他在埃及当宰相那个更高的目的是要养活神的选民。
God's higher purpose to make Joseph the prime minister in Egypt was to provide for God's people.
所以从二十一节我们可以看到约瑟说我要养活你们。
So in verse 21, Joseph told them, I will provide for you.
这个就是要完成神托付更高的目的。
This was in fulfillment of God's higher purpose.
那历史再回头过来看看约瑟这样做到底是怎么一回事。
And what does history teach us about Joseph's life?
这个非常的重要。
This is quite crucial.
因为已过的世代没有人纪念，将来的世代也没有人纪念。
Because the generations of the past are not remembered, and the generations of the future will not be remembered either.
这个是传道书里面在讲我们人生的一个定理。
And this is the rule of life according to the book of Ecclesiastes.
但是我们竟然在神面前如果完成更高的目的是会蒙神纪念的。
However, if we are able to fulfill God's higher purpose before God, we will be remembered by God.
所以如果我们看出埃及记的第一章。
Let's turn to Exodus chapter 1.
出埃及记第一章的第一节。
Chapter 1 of Exodus, verse 1.
请读。
Now these are the names of the children of Israel who came to Egypt. Each man in his household came with Jacob.
这个地方讲以色列的众子，以色列就是神的王子。
The children of Israel, and the name Israel means the prince of God.
来到埃及，这个埃及就是他寄居的地方。
They came to Egypt where Joseph was.
那如果我们看第六节
,Verse 6, and Joseph died, all his brothers and all that generation.
约瑟死了，也就是说约瑟当宰相这个戏台上演戏已经演完了。
Joseph was the prime minister and his role on the stage was completed.
所以他已经下台了。
And he has stepped off the stage.
但是他在当宰相这一台戏的影响到第七节。
But the influence that he exerted as the prime minister is evident in verse 7. 7, but the children of Israel were fruitful and increased abundantly, multiplied and grew exceedingly mighty, and the land was filled with them.
这个讲以色列神的选民生养众多繁荣茂盛强盛。
The children of Israel, God's people, were fruitful and increased abundantly.
这个就是神的目的。
This was God's purpose.
所以今天我们活在这个世界上。
Today, living in this world.
可能蒙神的祝福我们在地上都会有一些成就。
We may be blessed with different kinds of success in this world.
或者神把我们放在各个不同的地方。
And perhaps God places us in different roles.
那如果我们跟一般的人一样，就是把我们的工作做好，赚钱养家，那这样就离世了，那跟一般人并没有什么不同。
If we simply carry out our responsibilities and provide for our families, and then we die, we are really no different from other people.
但是我们在这个世界上如果能够去了解神今天造成的我是有什么更高的目的，那就更重要了。
However, if we are able to come to understand God's higher purpose in placing me where I am, then that would be the more important goal.
因为当我们把更高的目的把它活出来，我们就会成就神的旨意。
If we're able to fulfill God's higher purpose and calling, then we have fulfilled the will of God.
那这样，我们的生命在神看起来就是很有价值，很有意义。
And in the eyes of God, our life will be valuable and meaningful.
可能我们被人忘记，但是我们的一切都写在生命册上。
Perhaps others may eventually forget us, but everything that we have done will be recorded in the book of life.
如果我们看以斯帖记里面有记载 当时的以斯帖做了王后。
The book of Esther records how Esther became queen.
那她变成王后，这个也真的是有一只看不见的手一直带领把她推上去的。
And it was through the invisible hand that step by step Esther was elevated to the position of a queen.
但是到了当时的王要杀以色列百姓的时候。
When the king was about to annihilate the Jews, the Israelites.
那莫迪凯就去提醒他。
Mordecai came to remind Esther.
你今天做王后不是为着今天这个机会吗？
Is it not for this very day that you were made queen?
我们先来看以斯帖记。
Please turn to Esther.
以斯帖记的第四章。
Esther chapter 4.
十四节。
Verse 14.
第四章十四节，请读。
Esther chapter 4 verse 14.For if you remain completely silent at this time, relief and deliverance will arise for the Jews from another place, but you and your father's house will perish. Yet who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this?
这个地方讲，原指你得了王后的位分，不是为现今的机会吗？
Yet who knows whether you have come to the kingdom for such a time as this?
就是要救以色列百姓。
And this was to deliver the Jews.
这个就是神让他当王后更高的目的。
This was God's higher calling for Esther to be the queen.
真的，后来他完成了神对他的托付。
And true enough, Esther did fulfill God's commission for her.
所以从约瑟在埃及看到神对他有一个更美好的旨意，他一生努力去完成。
When Joseph realized God's higher purpose for him in Egypt, he made every effort to fulfill God's calling.
我们现在在美国要了解神到底要我们做什么。
Today we are in the United States. We need to understand what is God's purpose or will for us.
当然能够来到这个地方受好的教育在事业上有成，这是神的恩典。
Of course, to be able to come to this place to receive a good education and to be established in our career, all of these are God's blessings.
但是如果我们只享受了美好的人生就离世，有时候我们跟一般没有信仰人是不是也是差不多呢？
But if we are here only to enjoy a good life and then pass away,Then are we not any different from? Are we not different from the rest of the world?
所以我们一定要想到底神带我到美国来目的是什么。
So we need to think about what is God's purpose for us in bringing us to America.
那这样把它活出来，那我们在神面前就可以交账。
And once we realize our purpose, we need to live out that purpose, and then we will be able to give an account before God.
比方几年前，有的信徒看到这个网络的重要性。
For example, a few years ago, some church members took note of the importance of the internet.
就开始做建立这个 TJC.org 这个网站。
And they devoted themselves to building the TAC.org website.
有的在经济上大力的支援。
Some members offered a lot financially.
那有的在人力上做义工也是很出力的在出力。
And some people volunteered their time to help build the site.
所以我们今天到现在有一个 TJC.org 很美好的网站，这就是很多的信徒的努力。
Today, we're able to have a good TJC.org site, and this is all the result of all the contributions and effort of the members.
那现在我们这个网站要更充实，需要有更多的人力。
But in order to enhance the website, and to increase the content, we need more manpower.
但是更多的人力从哪里来？
But where can we get this manpower?
其实教会里面有很多的神所给很有恩赐的信徒。
Actually, in our church, God has given us many brothers and sisters who are very gifted.
但是他们都是为着生活在世界上工作。
Most of them are busy working in the world in order to provide for themselves and their families.
所以如果有更多人能够奉献，那有更多人能够自觉使命来献身，这样把它配合起来，我们这个网站就能够做得更好。
But if more members are willing to offer financially and more members are willing to dedicate themselves to the ministry, then we can make our website even better.
所以我们如果每个人能够自觉更高的目的，那这样把它活出来，我想我们教会会一直在兴旺。
If we can all come to realize God's higher purpose for us and try our best to fulfill that purpose, I'm sure the church will thrive.
我们现在大概有30个教会跟祈祷所。
Now we have about 30 churches and houses of prayer.
其实起初都是只有一两户的信徒。
In many places it started with only a couple of families.
他们就是有一个使命感，神带我这个地方来，要兴旺教会。
But these members had a sense of mission that God brought them to this place in order to raise up the God's church.
所以开始成立家庭聚会。
So they began family services.
成立祈祷所。
Prayer houses.
再来成立教会。
And eventually churches.
所以我们现在达到大概信徒数有4000个。
And now we have about 4,000 members in the U.S.
甚至这个教会要继续发展，需要有更多人有一种属灵上的自觉我一定有神托付我的目的。
But for the church to continue to grow, we need more people to come to the realization that God has given us this commission and a higher purpose.
其实约瑟虽然在埃及当宰相了，他的心并不在埃及。
Even though Joseph was prime minister in Egypt, his heart was not in the land of Egypt.
这个叫做信心。
This is faith.
所以信心不是一直求神成全我自己人生的计划。
So faith is not keep asking God to help us fulfill our own plans and ambitions.
那信心也不能够只限制在神迹奇事上面。
And faith should not be limited to only seeing signs and miracles.
信心是我们自觉，我是天上的国民，我在地上只是做客人。
Faith is a realization that we are but sojourners in this world, and we are heavenly citizens.
所以我们现在看希伯来书11章。
Please turn to Hebrews chapter 11.
希伯来书的11章。
Hebrews chapter 11.
22节。
Verse 22. Verse 22. By faith, Joseph, when he was dying, made mention of the departure of the children of Israel and gave instructions concerning his bones.
这个地方在讲约瑟到年纪大的时候。
When Joseph was old.
如果我们回到创世纪五十章。
Coming back to Genesis 50.
二十四节。
Let's read verse 24. Genesis 50, verse 24.Verse 24, and Joseph said to his brethren, I am dying, but God will surely visit you and bring you out of this land to the land of which he swore to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob.
所以仔细看哦，约瑟对他的兄弟说我要死了，但是他讲的是什么？神要把你带回到他应许的那块地。
Joseph told them, I am dying, but God will bring you back to the land of his promise.
所以这个是信心。
This is faith.
他的心不在埃及。
Because his heart was not in Egypt.
他不是对他的兄弟说，神一定祝福你，让你在埃及也繁荣昌盛。
He did not say to his brothers, God will surely bless you and you will prosper in the land of Egypt.
甚至约瑟本身在25节，请读。
In verse 25, then Joseph took an oath from the children of Israel saying,God will surely visit you, and you shall carry up my bones from here.
约瑟也希望他的骨头能够回葬到迦南地。Joseph's
wish was for his bones to be buried in the land of Canaan.
所以信心就是我们虽然我们身体活在这个世界，但是我们的心却是在神的国里面。Faith
means while living in this world bodily, our hearts need to be in the kingdom of God.
圣经来讲说，就我来讲，世界已经死了。
So in the Bible, it is stated as for me, the world has died.
所以这个就是信心了。This
is what faith is.
因此约瑟的信心的表现就是在三十岁能够看到神美好的旨意。So
Joseph's faith can be seen in the fact that he realized God's good intentions.
并且一直活到他死为止。
When he was 30 years old, and he lived it out until he died.
那如果我们回到刚刚读的50章,
please continue reading chapter 50 of Genesis.
50章的20节,
verse 20, Genesis 50, verse 20. But as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to bring it about as it is this day, to save many people alive.
这个地方在讲神的意思，还有你们的意思。We
can see in this verse the mention of what the brothers meant and what God meant.
所以约瑟的命运有一段时间是在他的兄弟的控制之下。For
a period of time, the Joseph's destiny was in the hand of his brothers.
但是这里讲神的意思是好的，也是讲说。 其实他的命运也是在神的控制之下。But
in this verse, we see that he also said God meant it for good. So his life was also in the hand of God.
所以我们的一生到底命运是谁在控制?
Who controls the destiny of our lives?
是天上的神呢? 还是我们周围的人呢? 还是我们自己呢?
Is it the God in heaven, or the people around us, or ourselves?
我们要从约瑟的故事再来思想这一个问题。
Let's ponder on this question through the story of Joseph.
如果我们看创世纪的45章,
please read Genesis 45.
创世纪的45章, 第五节,
Genesis chapter 45, verse 5. But now, do not therefore be grieved or angry with yourselves because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life.
这个地方, 我们仔细看, 有一句话叫做 六节啊, 卖, 你们把我卖到这里, 约瑟被卖。
The word sold can be seen in this verse. Joseph was sold to Egypt.
但是另外一个字就说, 神差我来。
Yet at the same time, we can see the expression, God sent me here.
那, 在人看起来，是他兄弟把他出卖。In
from the perspective of men, Joseph was sold by his brothers.
但是约瑟的了解，这是神差我来。But
for Joseph, it was God who sent him.
被卖变成被拆。He
was supposed to be sold, but he was sent.
所以。 人的旨意成全了，人的错误成全了神的旨意。So
the mistakes of men actually fulfilled God's will.
这个确实是给我们一个很大人生的指引。This
is a very important principle for us in our lives.
所以我们常常想说，我们人要不要算命？We
may wonder whether it's okay, whether we should go for fortune telling.
我们信主以后，我们就是属神的。But
after we have believed in the Lord, we belong to God.
所以，我们是圣洁的国度，属神的子民，君尊的祭司。We're
a holy nation, people belonging to God and royal priesthood.
在主耶稣里面，我们充充满满有恩典，有真理。In
the Lord Jesus Christ, we have abundant grace, true grace and truth.
因此，在主里面, 如果每一个人很认真追求神的国跟神的义，每个人的命都是好。
In the Lord Jesus Christ, if all of us seek God's kingdom and righteousness with fervor, we all have a good life and destiny.
所以有时候我们在想哦，人的命运是不是会被别人改变？
Sometimes I wonder whether other people can change our destiny.
如果我们看约瑟的故事，他被卖的时候，看起来好像他的命运已经被他哥哥掌控，被他哥哥改变了。
When Joseph was betrayed by his brothers, it seems as if his life, his destiny was completely under the control of his brothers.
因为他离开爱他的父亲。
And because of that, he left his beloved father.
他离开他的故乡
，He left his hometown，
所以好像他已经被他哥哥改变了。
It seems as if he was changed by his brothers。
但是到最后，我们发现他哥哥并没有改变他。
But ultimately, we come to realize that his brothers did not change his destiny。
那到底关键在哪里
？And what is the crux？
我们现在看《使徒行传》第七章。
Please turn to Acts chapter 7.
使徒行传的第七章。
Acts of the Apostles chapter 7.
第九节。
Verse 9.
还有第十节。
Acts chapter 7 verses 9 and 10. And the patriarchs, becoming envious, sold Joseph into Egypt, but God was with him, verse 10, and delivered him out of all his troubles and gave him favor and wisdom,in the presence of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and he made him governor over Egypt and all his house.
这个第九节讲哦，先祖嫉妒约瑟，把他卖到埃及。
Verse 9 tells us that the patriarchs became envious and sold Joseph into Egypt.
但是接下去马上讲，神却与他同在。
Yet the verse that follows immediately says, the sentence that follows immediately says, but God was with him.
这个神是掌控一切的。
God is, God exercises control over all things.
对，神与他同在。
God was with Joseph.
对，约瑟的命运啊，最重要是因为神跟他同在，所以他哥哥没有办法改变。
So the key is that Joseph's destiny was under God's control. So and even his brothers could not change it.
因为神给他同在，所以第十节啊，救他脱离一切的苦难。
Because God was with him, verse 10 tells us that he delivered him out of all his troubles.
那又使他在法老面前得恩，有智慧。
And gave him favor and wisdom in the presence of Pharaoh, king of Egypt.
那这个都是神的作为。
All of these were God's doing.
所以因为这样，法老就派他在埃及当宰相。
And for that reason, Pharaoh made him the prime minister of Egypt.
因此神跟我们同在哦，这个是我们一生命运的关键。
So if we have God with us in our lives, that is the key to a successful life.
神的带领一定会清楚，神的恩典一定会很丰富。
If God is with us, we can clearly feel God's guidance.And experience much of his grace.
但是环境的改变上上下下这是免不了的。
But the changes in our environment, the fluctuations of life are inevitable.
但是神要与约瑟同在是有条件的。
However, there was a condition to God being with Joseph.
我们看约瑟很有信心。
As we know, Joseph was a man of great faith.
Okay.他在任何一个环境真的是行公义，做神喜欢的事情。
Under any circumstance, Joseph exercised justice and did what was right in God's eyes.
如果我们想约瑟在波提法的家顺从祖母做了罪恶的事情，整个他的命运就不一样了。
Had Joseph yielded to his mistress in Potiphar's house and committed sin against God,then the entire course of his life would have changed.
因为神就不会再继续与他同在。
Because God would have no longer been with him.
那可能结果就不一样。
And the outcome would have been drastically different.
所以被卖人的错误可以成全神的旨意。
So even though he was sold, this was the mistake of men, yet it fulfilled God's will.
有时候我们在看圣经也有其他的例子。
We can see similar other examples in the Bible.
比方说约翰福音在讲当时的犹大。
For example, John was talking, John describes a Judas.
约翰福音13章27节。
Let's read John 13, verse 27.
约翰十三章的二十七节。
John 13, 27. Now, after the piece of bread, Satan entered him. Then Jesus said to him, "What you do, do quickly."
这里犹大给魔鬼留地步，所以魔鬼就进去然后主耶稣既然提醒不大，你要做的事，你就去快做吧。
Judas gave Satan a foothold, and after Satan entered him, Jesus said to him, what you do, do quickly.
但是到了约翰福音的十九章。
But as we reach John chapter 19,
我们看约翰福音十九章的三十节。
Please read John chapter 19, verse 30.
请读。
John chapter 19, verse 30. So when Jesus had received the sour wine, he said, it is finished. And bowing his head, he gave up his spirit.
我们记得马太福音把主耶稣来世界上的任务用一句话讲出来，他要把人从罪里面救出来。
Matthew describes in one statement Jesus' mission in this world, and that was to save his people from their sins.
然后在十九章的三十节成了，他真的把神要叫他做完成了。
And here in John chapter 19, verse 30, we read how Jesus said, "It is finished." Indeed.He finished God's commission on the cross.
因为在十字架流出宝血，成为赦罪的泉源，完成了。
On the cross, he shed his precious blood, which became the fountain of cleansing. So in that sense, he completed the commission.
犹大的错误成全了神的旨意。
Here we can see the error of Judah fulfilled the will of God.
这样我们就可以看得出来说，我们的一生最重要在神面前要做神喜悦的事情要有神的同在，那其他我们都交给神。
So we can see from this how important it is to do what pleases God, and then God will abide with us, and we can entrust everything else to Him.
我们就不需要有重担挂虑，神一定会带领。
We will not be burdened with anxieties or worries because God will, we know that God will guide us.
好，那我们现在回到五十章创世纪来看约瑟怎么处理跟他兄弟的关系。
Now let's return to Genesis 50 to read about how Joseph interacted with his brothers.
没有一个恨会比约瑟的跟没有一个关系会比约瑟跟他的哥哥更难解决的。
There is no human relationship that is more difficult than that of Joseph and his brothers.
因为从十七岁到三十岁这个受苦可以讲都是因为他的哥哥把他出卖。
We can essentially say that all his sufferings between the age of 17 and 30 was due to the betrayal of his brothers.
但是我们也看这么困难的问题一句话就解决了。
Yet at the same time, we can see that such a complicated and difficult relationship was resolved in one statement.
这个真的是我们在世界上很难看到。
And this is indeed hard to find in this world.
到底这个怎么解决？
How did Joseph resolve the conflict between them.
我们回到五十章的十九节。
Let's read Genesis chapter 50, verse 19.
你讲我岂能代替神呢？
Am I in the place of God?
他知道他不能代替神。
He knows he is not in the place of God.
所以神的意思既然好的。
If God meant it for good.
所以他怎么可以报复呢？
How can he take a revenge upon his brothers?
所以当他跟他哥哥的关系把神带进来的时候，他发现问题就解决了。
as soon as he brings God into the picture, the problem with his brothers was resolved.
所以有时候我们在世界上啊，不管是家庭的或人际关系啊，啊，如果没有把自己提到更高啊，这属灵层面来看，有时候真的是很难解决。
We can see that in our interpersonal relationships, including the relationship with our family members, can be extremely difficult to resolve without God.
啊，但是啊，如果我们能够看到神所看到的。
However, if we're able to see things from God's perspective, then many things can be resolved.
所以十七节啊，十八节啊，他的哥哥来俯伏在他面前。
Verse 18 says, then his brothers also went and fell down before his face.
十九节，约瑟对他讲，不要害怕。
Joseph said to them, verse 19, do not be afraid.
然后到二十一节
，verse 21，
就讲我要养活你们。
He said, "I will provide for you."
所以约瑟对他哥哥非常的好，因为他已经看到神美好的意思。
Joseph was so good to his brothers because he saw God's good intentions.
因此今天我们岂能够代替神呢？
Today, we need to ask, am I in the place of God?
让我们来思想神对我们更高的目的是什么。
Let's ponder what is God's higher purpose for us.
当别人对我们有错误的时候，让我们来相信神一定会带领我们到底，神的旨意会完全。
When others have wronged us, let us believe and trust that God will guide us to the end and His will be fulfilled.
但是我们本身一定要行神看为对的事情。
And as for we ourselves, we must continue to do what is right in the eyes of God.
以后我们要提到属灵的层面来看事情。
And from now on, let us elevate our eyesight to the spiritual, to a spiritual level, and see things from that perspective.
罗马书说万事互相效力。
In Romans, we are told that all things work for good.
叫爱神的益处。
To those who love God.
我们现在发生的疫情，这是非常负面的。
The pandemic we are experiencing now is extremely negative.
但是万事互相效力，这个万事也包括这个疫情。
But all things work together for good, and all things include a pandemic.
那怎么能够对我们变成有益处呢？
So how can it work for good, for our good?
我想我们明天再继续来查考。
We will continue this topic tomorrow.
我们来唱诗404首。
Let us now sing hymn 404.